Tonsy friends. Okay, so it's no joke. The warmer weather is here. And soon it's going to be summertime. That means that we can put away our jackets and our big warm sweaters and take out our summer clothes. Maybe some of you have already done that. But do you know where all of our summer clothing goes on our body? I wonder. Today, we're going to do this worksheet together. Here, it has all the different types of clothing that a person might wear in the summertime. And then on this side is all the different body parts. Do you know where all the clothing goes? First, we're going to start by coloring our pictures. So grab your markers and let's color.
But I've always loved the idea of summer and sun and all things hot.
Really? I'm guessing you don't have much experience with heat.
Nope. But sometimes I like to close my eyes and imagine what it'd be like when summer does come. Bees will buzz, kids will blow dandelion fuzz, and I'll be doing whatever snow does in summer. I drink in my hand, my snow up against the burning sand, probably getting gorgeously tanned in summer. I'll finally see a summer breeze blow away a winter storm, and find out what happens to solid water when it gets warm. And I can't wait to see what my buddies all think of me. Just imagine how much cooler I'll be in summer. The hot and the cold are both so intense. Put them together, it just makes sense. Winter's a good time to stay in and cuddle, but put me in summer and I'll be
alright. So now that I've cut out all my body parts, it's time to figure out where does the clothing belong. So let's take a look at our sheet. Do you know what this is? It's a hat or a cap. And where does a hat or a cap go? That's right, it goes on our head. Let's check out what Mandy has to say the Cree word for head is.
For head in Cree, we say mistikwan. Mistikwan.
Thanks, Miss Mandy. All right, guys, so let's take our glue stick and glue our head onto the box beside the hat. There we go. Now it says a cap on my head. All right, let's take a look at the next picture. Do you know what these are? They're shoes or sandals. Sandals are what people wear in the summertime. And where do sandals go on our body? That's right, they go on our feet. Great work. Hey, Miss Mandy, what's the Cree word for feet?
For feet, we'd say misita. Misita.
Thanks, Miss Mandy. All right, so I'm going to take my feet and I'm going to glue them beside my sandals. Now, I'm only using a little bit of glue because remember, we only need a little bit. So I'm going to put a little bit of glue right there and I'm going to stick my feet just like that. All right. So now let's take a look at our next piece of clothing. It's a t-shirt. Do you know where a t-shirt goes? That's right, it goes on our body and on our arms. Miss Mandy, what's the Cree word for arms?
For arms, we would say mispituna. Miss Pituna.
Thanks, Miss Mandy. All right, so let's take our picture with the upper body and arms and glue it beside our t-shirt. I'm only using a little bit of glue. There we go. Wow, we're almost done. Next is shorts. Do you know where shorts go? Great job! Shorts go on our legs. Miss Mandy, what's the Cree word for legs?
So, our legs, we would say miskata. Miskata.
All right, thanks, Miss Mandy. So, I'm going to take my picture of the legs, and you guessed it, I'm going to glue it beside my shorts. There we go. All right, next it's time to figure out where this goes. Do you know what this is? They're bathing suits. And where do bathing suits go? They go on our body. This is the picture of the body. Can you glue it beside your bathing suits? Just like that. All right, guys, we've done so good. We have one more matchup left. Do you know what these are? Great job. They're sunglasses. And where do sunglasses go? On our eyes. Miss Mandy, how do we say eyes in Cree?
So for eyes, we would say miskisikwa. Miskisikwa.
Thanks, Miss Mandy. And here's my last picture. It's of some eyes. So I'm going to put some glue. And I'm going to stick on my eyes. Just like that. Now we're almost done. We have one more thing to do. And that is print our name. So get your name book and see how your name is spelled. Or maybe you don't even need your name anymore. Go ahead and write your name on the top line, right there. All right, so here's what your finished page should look like. You'll have your name up at the top, and then you'll have all your body parts next to the right articles of clothing. And if you really want to show off how smart you are, here's how you read your page to someone. At the top it says, in the summer I wear a cap on my head, sandals on my feet, a t-shirt on my upper body, shorts on my legs, a bathing suit on my body, and sunglasses on my eyes. Wow! Well, guys, take a picture of what your sheet looks like. What colors did you use to color your pictures? And did you line up all the body parts to the pieces of clothing just like mine? I can't wait to see. And don't forget, in the summer, it's also very important that we wear sunscreen on all parts of our body that aren't covered in clothing. That helps keep our body safe from the sun so we don't get sick. All right, friends, now I'm going to go outside and enjoy this nice weather. Ex maga!